the 16 nations represented on the Committee of European Economic Cooperation sets this forth, I think, in a convincing manner. As a result of the war, the European community, which for centuries had been one of the most productive and indeed creative forces of the inhabited world, was left first-rate. Russia, nonetheless, enjoys a Cuban heritage and a Cuban civilization. The war ended with the leaders of the major areas meeting in the heart of this community. The promises of three of them have been directed to the restoration of that European community. It is now clear that only one power, the Soviet Union, does not, for its own reasons, share this aim. We have become involved in two wars, which have had their origins in the European continent. The free peoples of Europe have fought two wars to prevent the forcible domination of their community by a single white power. Such domination would have inevitably menaced the stability and security of the world. To deny it today, our interest in their ability to defend their own heritage would be to disclaim the efforts and sacrifices of two generations of Americans. We wish to see this community restored as one of the pillars of world security, in a position to renew its contribution to the advancement of mankind, and to the development of a world order based on law and respect for the individual. The Committee of European Economic Cooperation, meeting in Paris, produced a recovery program extending over 4 years. After the most careful checking, with the assistance of experts drawn from many governmental agencies,